Well, welcome to Duff Cottage. This is a tea party to celebrate and mark the day museums come home. We're in the Wordsworth's kitchen parlour and we're sitting surrounded by things that perhaps would have made up their table at such an occasion. I'm sitting with, I should say, most of the things we see are facsimiles, so don't worry about them being damaged, including Wordsworth's waistcoat, a facsimile of his waistcoat. A nice copy of Dorothy Wordsworth's journal, a nice copy of our notebook, one of William's notebooks that's based on the original. We have a letter that might just have arrived, of course quills and ink that would have been in every room of the house perhaps. Tea, so we've got the teacup without a handle from the 1790s. And the tea that they drank, we know that Mr. Twining visited in August 1800, so we imagine they're drinking Twining's tea. This is Twining's tea in this cup, courtesy of what we had at home. Tea bags, of course, and decaffeinated, so probably not anything like they would have had, but it's the best we can do in these circumstances. We know too that they did a lot of home baking, and we have the recipe book of William's sister-in-law, Joanna. And in there is a recipe for ginger snaps. And a Grasmere resident, Nicole, has made ginger snaps based on the recipe that's in the notebook that they kept. And this is a special moment to take them out of the bag and just to look at them and to try them. I have to say, they smell absolutely delicious. I guess it's ginger, but it has treacle with it, and it has a lot of sugar in it as well, so it's probably got quite a crunch, but really wonderful. So try out Joanna's recipe, it's absolutely wonderful, and thank you Nicole for making these. This is an important part of the Wordsworth lives. The fire was such an important part of home. We're talking about museums from home. Well, the home for the Wordsworths. Fire is mentioned in Dorothy's journal something like 63 times, and in terms of tea drinking, she mentions drinking tea 72 times. So those are mentions over a two-year period when we have the journals that have survived. And tea drinking was with the family, but it was also with friends and guests who would come to the house. Typically the Reverend Simpson would come and play cards and drink tea. And so thinking about the Wordsworths in this lockdown moment, we might think, well, they would miss the guests. But Wordsworth tells us in one of his poems that actually he's equally at ease and at home sitting by the fire without news of local goings-on. This is a poem called Personal Talk, and it was written between 1802 and 1804, we think. And he talks about sitting by this very fire in this poem, and he talks about the pleasure of sitting alone and of thinking, and the pleasure of reading. And he comes to the conclusion, or at least he makes the point, about the importance of poets. And so I'm just going to read a few lines from it. I am not one who much or oft delight to season my fireside with personal talk about friends who live within an easy walk, or neighbours daily, weekly, in my sight. And then he says, better than such discourse doth silence long, long, barren silence square with my desire to sit without emotion, hope, or aim by my half kitchen, my half parlour fire, and listen to the flapping of the flame, or kettle whispering its faint undersong. So rather than listen to the local news and the local gossip, Wordsworth would happily sit here and think and read. Dreams, books are each a world, and books we know are a substantial world, both pure and good. Round these, with tendrils strong as flesh and blood, our pastime and our happiness will grow. There do I find a never failing store of personal themes, and such as I love best. Matter wherein right voluble I am. Two will I mention, dearer than the rest, the gentle lady. Spencer. And then he concludes the poem, "Blessings be with them, and eternal praise, who gave us nobler loves and nobler cares, the poets, who on earth have made us heirs of truth and pure delight by heavenly lays. Oh, might my name be numbered among theirs, then gladly would I end my mortal days." So I guess Wordsworth writing this, of course, before he became famous, talking of his own ambition, and by the fact that we're sitting here celebrating Wordsworth's 250th birthday this month, perhaps we just have to assume that Wordsworth, he achieved his aim and is considered as one of the great poets.